man who's broadcasting the games, Patrick McEnroe, he had the virus. Fortunately, he's now healthy, and he's excited to get things going. Tonight, we're going one-on-one with Patrick, and here's a look at just some of our conversation. Right now is such a bizarre time, and there's other adjectives. You're a Stanford grad. You could probably choose a different adjective, but it's a bizarre time as the U.S. Open is getting ready to get back in action. What is the word that you would use, Patrick?
Well, this probably wouldn't come from my Stanford background.
Yeah.
Weird. Okay. It's definitely kind of weird. I've been out at the site of the U.S. Open this week. I feel like the entire facility at Flushing Meadows has now become like an oversized player lounge.
So here's the thing, Patrick. It's interesting because I've interviewed your brother, John, many times. This is the first time you and I have actually gotten a chance to speak. And you both have very different temperaments. Am I wrong about that?
You're not entirely wrong about that, no. You know, my brother is known for a lot of things.
Yeah, like what?
You cannot be serious!
Being an amazing tennis player, but being a little, you know, over the top sometimes with his attitude. And that's probably partly what made him great. And, you know, growing up as his little brother, I used to see that a lot. And I was a little rambunctious as a kid, as a teenager, playing tennis. Uh-huh. But my dad used to always say to me, you don't want to get into the same trouble as your brother. Everybody's watching you. You got to be quiet. And of course, then I realized where this came from, because my dad was a pretty intense dude. You know, he'd raise his voice a lot. So I would listen to my dad and my brother argue. And then I would see the reaction that my brother would get. I was, you know, a little more mild-mannered anyway. So that, but that definitely affected me as a kid and as a tennis player. Maybe if I'd had a little more of his attitude, maybe I could have been a better tennis player. Who knows?
Was it competitive between you two? Did you guys have that kind of competitive energy growing up?
Oh, definitely. Mostly at the ping pong table, because in ping pong, I actually had a chance to beat my brother playing ping pong. So we used to, we used to have to retape the paddles because we used to throw them against the wall. And we used to play in our garage in the basement. We used to have to rewrap them. And then my dad would yell out, what's going on down there? Shut up down there.
Listen, the next time you and John have a little match, I would like to be out there to facilitate things. Was that okay? Can I take that role?
Yeah, you could definitely do that. We'd love to have you. We still hit the ball pretty well. We're not moving quite as quickly as we used to, but we still, if we play a set or play a game to 21, it's game on.
It's game on. And speaking of game on, we're going to air this come Sunday. So tomorrow, it's game on. U.S. Open finally back in action. Very different this year. Your final words, Patrick, on why people should be excited to watch this year.
Well, you're going to see amazing tennis. I mean, I've seen great tennis this week. It's going to be different. It's going to be unique. It's going to be some negatives to it, obviously. But the positives will be there's going to be professional tennis at the highest level. And I've been asked this many times over the last few months. And here's my answer to sum it up. Would you rather have a U.S. Open with no fans or no U.S. Open? I'll take the U.S. Open with no fans.
I'm right there with you. Patrick McEnroe, we appreciate your time. It's great to talk to a fellow card.
You got it. Go card. Go tree.
I liked how he gives the thumbs up. You know, it's just fun watching the Islanders right now. They're enjoying this moment. Very loose, but somehow